Dream, we talk about fights that we're going to see at the Great American Bash next Sunday. I don't think you're going to see a fight any bigger than the one between Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green. I witnessed that firsthand when Green was up at our broadcast location on Nitro a few weeks back, and here came Mongo, and that's as close as I really want to get to those two men. Two of the strongest, most successful football players ever. And Mongo can be considered one of the most successful wrestlers.
So far, but Tony, you know when you got good fights? Is when you got two people that are in it, are not really schooled in the art of fighting. What I mean by that is professional wrestling, okay? So Green knows one thing. I'm gonna go across, tackle him, bite his ear, hit him as hard as I can, do whatever. Mongo's just learning this trade. So you got a good fight brewing there because they are not technicians. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
They're gonna be hog wild if I can use coin the phrase for my great event that will be coming up later on this summer. But hog wild is the key there. They're gonna go for it. And you're right. Being in the same building with all that is gonna be electric.
Well, Sister Sherri very happy that her duo has signed now to meet the Steiner brothers for the number one contender slot coming up at the Great American Bash. Winner of the Steiners, Harlem Heat, to face the winner of the Outsiders, Ric Flair, Lex Luger World Tag Team title match at our pay-per-view in August. Of course, that's Hog Wild from Sturgis, South Dakota, and the big guy of the Power Company with a crossbody nicely done on Booker T. And how about this?
Yeah, the big guys from the Power, the Power Company, is they big. They want to learn. They say, give me a match. I'll go in there with former five-time world tag team champions. It don't matter. They just are ready to go in here and get them a victory. But always you have that anticipation that Harlem Heat could slip and the Powers, they become victorious. And that's what makes pro wrestling so great, not knowing what's going to happen, being able to go ahead and compete.
Based on what happened this past Monday, though, because they lost and because the Steiners lost, I would think the intensity here is just
too much. Why did the Steiners lose?
Because of Harlem Heat.
There you go.
And why did Harlem Heat lose? Because of the Steiners.
Well, then they need to beat each other.
That's right.
Right.
That's exactly what needs to happen. Fans in Macon, Georgia, Monday, June 23rd, Nitro comes there live at the Macon Coliseum. Tickets to the box office and Ticketmaster locations. Look forward to going back to Macon.
Yeah, you won't be able to get in there you better get a cover wagon, get there early.
That's
after
right.
Coming from Boston, going into Macon.
Wow.
All my fans down there, I'm going to tell you what, they'll be coming across that Otis Redding Bridge early and lining up for that thing, brother. And I'm going to knock
somebody out. Boy, the demeanor of Harlem Heat. They already are in a bad mood, and now even more so. Look at this hook. He'll try to pick him up. Butterfly suplex, maybe. Oh, my goodness.
And that's a heavy load. I go out on a limb right here and say Harlem Heat, as me being a broadcast journalist in here with you the past couple of years, being able to see these guys up close, not being able to compete with them. But I really believe Harlem Heat is the tag team of the Niners so far here at WCW. They've been world champions so much. But Steiner's coming back and wanting to regain that. What makes this an intriguing matchup? I really believe that. You ain't going to give me no... that good or bad? Do you believe that too, or you just?
No, I don't know. I don't know what to think about that match.
I think Harlem Heat is the team to beat. You beat them, you're there. You know what I'm talking about? That's what I'm saying.
Tag made, and here comes Booker T. Actually, Stevie Ray still in there. You know, it goes down, Dream, when you get teams evenly matched. Who can double team the best?
Yeah.
And like a maneuver like that, that's a double team maneuver. That's the Big Apple, and that should be it.
Yeah, you gotta, got him. You gotta double team and get out before the count. You gotta be able to keep the guy over in your turf, do all them things, make great tag team. We've seen one here tonight on Saturday night, right here on the mothership. They continue to summer mud hole in this young man right here. But you know what I mean, if you're gonna play, look here, Tony.
Here they come!
Wow!
The Steiners!
They come out of nowhere!
I didn't know they were here! The Steiners are here to attack Harlem Heat again!
Oh, baby! Yeah! The Bad Dogs in town! Scotty and Rick, they lit it up!
Now who's the bad team? Get out of his way!
Look at that on that slob on that. He bit that rope hard.
He bit it hard.
Yeah, he didn't just walk up to kiss it. Tried to bite it in half. That's what happened when the adrenaline starts flowing.
Wow, what a match it's going to be. Tag team, number one contender match. Yeah, I know, but yeah, thank you. The contract has been signed.
Harlem Heat really on top of the ball game. And I tell you something, they are ready and right. The Power Company, no match at this point of their career for Harlem Heat. But the Steiners getting ready to do business with the Heat, if you know what I'm talking about. Rick and Scotty making their way in.
Another man who suffered a loss in Nitro was Hugh Morse, thanks to Conan. And he's standing by with Lee Marshall right now.